Class of 2015, as you complete this phase of your journey and commence the next, let's be in a spirit of prayer, openness, and peace. Please join me in a word of prayer. Dear God, how good it is to be here today. We are grateful for these past 4 years and for all that we have shared with one another, learning, questions, friendship, experiences. We thank you for the 149 years of inspiration behind a commitment to seek the truth that has brought us to this place, and we ask you to grant each student here today continued passion for seeking truth as each prepares to continue to pursue their calling, the work that you have etched into their hearts. As a companion to that commitment, Lord, we pray that you would grant each one compassion. Compassion to notice the needs and vulnerabilities of those on the sidelines in our society. Move their hearts and their hands to help those in need, people who have been marginalized. And Lord, we pray for continued inspiration. Lead us to dream of a healthier, less fragmented society. Call us to ways that will build a sense of community despite differences. Dear God, use these ceremonies today to fill us with a spirit of commitment and a spirit of compassion that will sustain each one and all through all that today and tomorrow will bring. May it be so. Alleluia. Amen. You may be seated.
Good morning. Good morning. All right. Welcome to the 146th commencement exercises at Lebanon Valley College. What a happy day for all of us. I'd like to extend a very special welcome to the family and friends of the graduating class. I just spoke with those who are gathered in Arnold Fieldhouse, who are watching this ceremony next door, a front row seat to a gigantic video screen. I'd like us all to have a show of support for and connection with everyone in Arnold. So let's raise a ruckus and let them know we care. Hear, hear. That was an extremely good ruckus. I know that many of you have come a long way to see your student graduate. Is there anything more rewarding than seeing the success of our children or those we love? Your journey and your student's journey can often be measured in more than miles, and we know that journey for some is longer than others. On this joyous occasion, I ask the members of the class of 2015 to stand and join me in expressing our gratitude to those family members and friends who made it possible for you to graduate today. Please join me by standing and offering a round of applause to family and friends. Thank you. Last night, I was inspired by Rose Berger's baccalaureate address in the chapel on stickers and boomers. I visited with many families after the baccalaureate service in our reception in the on the social quad. And I told one family that I was definitely a sticker because I didn't even want these good students to leave. Every year, we would have more and more good students coming one right after the other. But the younger brother of our graduate, Amisha Lala, immediately gave me a practical suggestion. "President Thain, then you should only graduate the bad students. It's too late for this class, but I'm going to work on that next year, 2016. To the members of the class of 2015, you are graduating from one of the finest colleges in America. You have an education that very few people in your global generation will experience, an education of the whole person in active collaboration with a dedicated faculty that prepares you to do great work. I say to you, wear your Lebanon Valley degree lightly, but know its value. Many of the parents here are thinking about a job. They're not thinking about their job, they're thinking about your job. Be confident. You have an education that will get you a job. More importantly, you have the intellectual skills refined in the classrooms and laboratories and residence halls, individually and in collaboration with others, that will last your entire career and your entire life. Moreover, I have good news. The job market is strong and getting stronger for those with an education. Your accomplishments here are many, and they have prepared you well for the next set of challenges you will encounter. In the process of completing your degree, you have made the college a better place and shaped its history. This is your college. It will always be your college. I ask you to do always what you can to make Lebanon Valley College a better place. May I ask you now to stand again and offer thanks and a round of applause for the faculty and staff who have made, and the coaches and others who have made your experience here what it is. If you would, please join me again. Thank you. I would like to add a special greeting to the senior members of our softball team competing today in the NCAA regional tournament in Alfred, New York. They have a specially designed graduation ceremony planned, quite different from this one. Several members of our women's lacrosse team will need to leave immediately after receiving their diplomas to depart for the semifinals of the ECAC tournament later today. A round of applause for this group of winners. Hear, hear. Go Valley. Finally, I want to issue a call to action. Go out and accomplish great things and make the world a better place through your actions, large and small. You are living in a time of discovery and of possibility we could not have imagined even 20 years ago. You are needed in the world in so many ways. I speak for all of us at the college when I tell you how much we admire you and admire the energy and sense of purpose that you have and you've brought here and you take with you. The world needs leaders like you. I have said to my own children when they went to college, become an interesting person. you have become interesting people. Go out and live interesting lives and help others. I'd like to ask now family and friends to stand with me and to give this class, the class of 2015, a round of applause for what they have accomplished. Thank you very much. That was great. And this is why they call it the commencement exercises. I would now like to introduce Mr. Wesley Dellinger, class of 1975, and chair of the Board of Trustees. Mr. Dellinger's family connections to the college go back 5 generations. He and Dean Michael Green, Vice President of Academic Affairs and Dean of the Faculty, will present the awards to distinguished faculty members. Thank you.
I just realized that 125 years ago today, my great-grandfather walked across the stage somewhere here on campus to receive his diploma. So I feel like I have a responsibility to fill his footsteps. I am Wes Dellinger, class of 1975, and congratulations to the class of 2015. It is an honor to be an alumnus and to have an opportunity to serve our great institution as chair of our Board of Trustees. And it is my privilege as a representative of the 16,000 LVC graduates worldwide to welcome you into the LVC Global Network as fellow alumni. Your connection to Lebanon Valley College will continue to grow through time. As alumni, you have access to others with a personal tie to the Valley. You will be encouraged to give back to the institution that has given you so much. Share your talents by offering internships and employment opportunities with LVC students who will soon be on this stage as well. Offer to visit campus to share your experiences in the classrooms of your favorite professors. Serve as an admission advocate and an ambassador in your community, telling your individual LVC story. Come back to the campus often. The campus you have called home. You don't want to miss homecoming this October. And yes, give as you are able to support future generations of students with scholarships and programs that will shape them into a group of alumni who will follow in your footsteps. Know as you leave this place that you become part of a global network of LVC alumni. Once again, congratulations to the class of 2015. Your fellow alumni celebrate with you today. And now, with an appreciation for the life-changing role innovative and inclusive teaching plays at the college, it is appropriate that we acknowledge its centrality and significance by presenting prestigious teaching awards to 2 illustrious faculty members. I now ask Dean Green to announce the recipients of these rewards.
Good morning. The Nevlin J. Nisley and Thomas Reese Vicary Awards recognize individual faculty members for outstanding teaching in and outside of the classroom. Each year, a committee reviews faculty nominations and then selects recipients based on criteria that include subject matter expertise, innovative teaching pedagogy, effective use of learning assessment techniques, and the ability to engage students and to stimulate critical thinking and problem solving. It is my honor to present the awardees for the 2014-15 academic year. The Thomas Rees Vicray Award for Teaching is awarded annually at commencement to a full-time member of the faculty who has demonstrated the highest standards of teaching and professional commitment to students learning at the college. The Vicroy awardee also has the honor of giving the commencement address at the next year's ceremonies. Our Vicroy recipient this year is known for his teaching excellence in one of the college's more difficult and challenging courses. In his nomination letter, he was acknowledged for his ability to make the subject matter fun and highly interactive, while at the same time elevating the academic rigor and his expectations for student performance and success. He was praised for doing a masterful job of connecting the principles of the subject matter to the discipline-specific focus that each student brings to the course. The objective measures of his teaching success can also be seen on standardized test performance within his discipline and through excellent ratings on course evaluations. Over the past 10 years at the college, our nominee has worked with 47 students in undergraduate research during the summer and academic years. 15 of his research students have co-authored a total of 5 peer review publications in scientific journals. His students have had exceptional placement success in industry positions, medical schools, and top-tier graduate schools, including Johns Hopkins, Penn State, Princeton, and Columbia. Our recipient has been awarded 4 nationally competitive external grants that total more than $500,000. One of the most impressive accomplishments is a grant award from the National Science Foundation to support multiple LVC science students in a highly immersive 10-week international undergraduate research experience in Budapest, Hungary over the next 3 years. In addition to these excellent accomplishments in teaching and scholarship, our awardee has been a leader in the development of the learning outcomes assessment culture on our campus. He has also been an avid supporter of teaching and learning initiatives that improve student learning campus-wide. His passion for teaching and his enthusiasm for the subject area was something that stood out in his nomination materials. All of the recommendation letters emphasize his genuine care for students and his willingness to provide extra assistance as needed. One student wrote, "He is very willing to facilitate students in developing careers and paths beyond the confines of LVC's undergraduate degree, and often has realistic insight to where the student can flourish." Our awardee embodies the ideal of the teacher-scholar model at Lebanon Valley College, combining excellence in the classroom with impressive, high-impact undergraduate research. Would you all please help me recognize the 2015 Thomas Vicroy Distinguished Teaching Award recipient, Dr. Timothy Peelan. In 1988, Lebanon Valley College began to honor part-time and adjunct members of the faculty for excellence in teaching. Named after an outstanding instructor, the Nevelyn J. Nisley Award for Inspirational Teaching is awarded annually at graduation. Our Nisley honoree was selected for her excellent work in our education department, where she has been teaching secondary education courses in practicum and methods, as well as content area literacy. In letters of nomination from students and fellow faculty members, she was praised for her work in literacy education and her ability to engage students with a myriad of creative strategies that students can use across all content areas of teaching. One student summed up her experience with this student by saying, "She is a very passionate, kind, energetic, and engaging teacher. She clearly has experience applying the information she covers in a modern-day classroom and brings that experience and confidence with the material to every lesson. Another education student writes, "She taught me more than I ever thought I'd learn, and I left her class with a broad range of ideas and strategies to implement in my own classroom." Along with her adjunct work at Lebanon Valley College, she is recognized as an outstanding educator of language arts at Northern Lebanon Middle School. She has received numerous teaching awards that include her induction into the Lebanon County Educational Honor Society and her selection as a finalist for the Pennsylvania Teacher of the Year Award in 2013. Our education department faculty believe she embodies what it means to be an exceptional teacher and expressed how fortunate they are to have this nominee working with our students. For her excellence in teaching in our education department, we are pleased to present the 2015 Nevelyn J. Nisley Award to Denise Williams. Congratulations again to both of these recipients. I would now like to invite Daniel Kimmel, class of 2014, to the podium to introduce our commencement speaker.
Good morning. In Teaching to Transgress, a book that calls for excellent and engaged teaching, bell hooks writes, "Certainly it was naive for me to imagine during high school that I would find spiritual and intellectual guidance in university settings from writers, thinkers, and scholars. To have found this would have been to stumble across a rare treasure. During my time here at Lebanon Valley College, I experienced the great fortune of stumbling across many rare treasures, and it is my honor to introduce one of them to you today. I do not know the total number of students' lives that he has influenced, but I can tell you that he greatly influenced mine through his patient and persistent intellectual and spiritual guidance. He is challenging, compassionate, and present within and outside of the classroom, pouring extra time and effort into his students' experiences here at LVC. I am certain that those who have had the privilege of having him in class will never think quite the same about life's great questions again. I do not mean to speak for her, but if I had to venture a guess, I would say that bell hooks would be proud that LVC contains such a treasure. With that, it is my pleasure to introduce today's commencement speaker, Dr. Matthew Sayers.
Good morning, President Thain, trustees, Dean Green, distinguished guest staff, and fellow faculty. Welcome to family and friends, and congratulations to graduating seniors. I'm honored to speak at this culminating moment of your time here at LVC. Inscribed upon the stone walls of our library are the words of Jesus Christ, as told to us by the gospel writer John, "You shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free." For John, this meant freedom from sin and the promise of salvation. But what do these words mean inscribed upon the walls of a college library? Truth. The Greek word for truth, aletheia, is a negation of the verb lantano, to be hidden, to be unaware, to shut one's eyes to. One lexicon tells us that the word truth stresses undeniable reality when something is fully tested. That is, it will ultimately be shown to be fact. So truth means what is not hidden. And if truth has any moral value, what should not be hidden, what we should not shut our eyes to. But so much is hidden from us by ignorance or fear, by those who would intentionally hide the truth. And there is so much about which we are unaware because of a lack of time or resources, or because we, perhaps unconsciously, shut our eyes to it. Some of our ideas resist being tested. Others can never be fully tested. But even if we trust that it will ultimately be proven fact, what do we do in the meantime? Knowledge. Dr. Sartorius, a character in the film Solaris, may offer us some help. He says, "Man was created by nature so he could learn her ways. In this endless search for truth, he's condemned to knowledge. Everything else is whim." The search for truth is endless, not only because of our own ignorance or fear, not only because some truths cannot be tested, but also because we live in an ever-changing world. The dynamic nature of reality, if not denying the existence of eternal truths, makes it impossible for us to fully grasp them. Thus, we're condemned to knowledge. We're condemned to learn. We're condemned to the limits of knowledge, and we're condemned to the burdens of knowledge. Condemnation. Knowledge necessarily starts with the self, but the Delphic maxim to know thyself is only a beginning. As we grow, we learn. We come to know not only ourselves, but also others, the world around us, and something of how that world came to be, how it is. But sometimes what we learn is uncomfortable. Gloria Steinem is right when she says, "The truth will set you free, but first it will piss you off." Nor is it an accident that we speak of the ugly truth. And learning itself can be uncomfortable. What we know is a large part of who we are, but learning requires us to change what we know. That can generate fear, because when we change what we know, we change who we are. None of us are the same person we were in second grade or even in high school. We're condemned to learn because learning imposes upon us perpetual change, but change need not be as scary as it often seems. There are many unavoidable limits of knowledge, such as a human lifespan or the untestability of a truth. But often, we're stymied only by the self-imposed limits of fear or pride. Fear shuts our eyes to truth to keep us safe from change. Pride shuts our eyes to truth because we believe we already know the truth. We're condemned to the limits of knowledge because we are human, but we need not accept more limits than are inherent in our humanity. We all know that old cliche, knowledge is power. Slave owners knew the power of knowledge and often withheld literacy from slaves in order to keep them in chains. The authors of our mission and those of us who work to fulfill it seek to empower students with knowledge because we know that knowledge is power. In a world inundated with information, knowledge is great power. But as my Uncle Ben once said, with great power, there must also come great responsibility. All too often, we speak of education as a necessity, saying, "I need a degree to get a job." We seek a piece of paper, a token to drop in the subway turnstile of life, a paper currency with which to buy a future. But education is not merely a pass to the next stage of life. Education is a privilege, and as such, it demands of us responsibility. We must take the power that knowledge grants us seriously. Knowledge cannot be merely a tool for our own self-advancement. You did not gain knowledge by yourself. Why should you be able to use it only for your own good? Our mission speaks of a life of service to others and says that we empower students for a life of learning, citizenship, and success. If you would embody the best of what LVC has to offer, you must find ways to use that power to empower others. But as we search for truth, we find nice spots along the way to stop, nice comfortable places where we can be relieved of our burdens. If we mistake these comforts for the end of the search, we may resent those still searching or see them as fools passing the goal out of pride or vanity. This is why the college mission emphasizes lifelong learning. Learning requires a lifetime. We never finish the endless search for truth. We're condemned to knowledge. Another character in Solaris, when asked about the meaning of life and other eternal things, says, "The happiest people are those who are not interested in these cursed questions." If we take seriously the power inherent in knowledge, the responsibility that comes with the quest for truth, are we doomed to leave happiness behind? In the time-honored tradition of the commencement addresses, let me end with advice on how to stay true to the quest for truth, seek freedom, and perhaps find happiness as well. Be courageous. It takes little courage for someone who loves the sound of their own voice to give a public address like this one. You can only be brave when you feel fear. I want to praise the courage of the climber who scales a mountain despite a fear of heights, the courage of the drummer who plays on despite stage fright. I want to inspire in you the courage to question what you know in order to learn and grow, despite the fear that you might be wrong. For you can only grow, you can only gain knowledge when you face this fear. Laugh. We could understand Dr. Sartorius's comment that everything else is whim as dismissing anything beside the pursuit of truth as trivial, but whim is a necessary part of that search. You don't need to laugh as often or as loudly as I do. You don't need to make everyone laugh, but you do need someone in your life that can make you laugh, someone you can laugh with, because without laughter, all of this is simply too much. Be compassionate. It's all too easy to wield power thoughtlessly. Cartoonish villains that crush innocent people without thought don't exist often in the real world. But who hasn't lashed out with a hurtful comment because it was the only power you could wield? If you're in the majority in America and you vote solely out of self-interest, you employ the power of democracy as Marvin Simkin described it, two wolves and a lamb voting on what to eat for lunch. You will live in a diverse and fragile world pursuing both citizenship and success. And because of your education, you know more of how that world works. You can use that knowledge to gain your own freedom, but compassion should drive you to work for the freedom of everyone, especially the lambs. It should drive you to work for everyone's success. As Solomon Burke sings, none of us is free if one of us is chained. Be yourself. I've saved the worst cliche for last. Trite, yes, overused, probably. But being yourself, with so many people telling you who you are and how to act, is tougher than it sounds. Your body, a biological machine rife with hormones that drive your behavior, enables you and constrains you. Your parents shape who you are through nearly every moment of your life. Friends and teachers influence you throughout childhood. Religion tells you what is good, what is sin. Culture tells you how to be a man, a woman, an adult, what to laugh at, how to talk, and who to love. Yet when asked if we act of our own free will, we shut our eyes to all of this and answer, of course. If freedom is found in truth, then each step taken in search of truth grants us not only more knowledge, but more freedom. You will never be completely free of the influences of your bodies, nor of the pressures of your culture. But the more you know of your body and your culture, the less they determine who you are, then the more you do. The search for truth will grant you freedom, scrap by precious scrap. I encourage you to continue the search, to remember to find your own voice in the cacophony of our modern world, and with the lyrics of Jimi Hendrix, I urge you to draw upon courage, laughter, and compassion to empower others to do the same. White-collar conservative flashing down the street, pointing their plastic finger at me. They're hoping soon my kind will drop and die, but I'm gonna wave my freak flag high, high. Wave on, wave on. Fall, mountains, just don't fall on me. Go ahead on, Mr. Businessman, you can't dress like me. Sing on, brother, play on, drummer.
An honorary degree is the highest honor any institution of higher education can bestow. Lebanon Valley College confers this honor only on those individuals who have made exceptional contributions to society or to the college specifically, and who have distinguished themselves in an endeavor consistent with the college's commitment to lifelong learning, inclusive excellence, and service to others. Mr. Sheldon Gershon Yakis is an immensely successful recording engineer and mixer who has worked with some of the most popular musicians of our time. As Jeff Snyder, the director of our music business program, noted in his nomination of Mr. Yakis, there are very few people on the planet who haven't heard Shelley's work. Despite the incredible pressures on his time, Shelley Yakis served as an adjunct instructor at Lebanon Valley College from 1998 to 2003. He returned in 2013 to speak at the student-run Vail Music Industry Conference. His dedication to our students has made a huge impact in their lives, and we thank him for continuing to be part of the Lebanon Valley College community.
Mr. President, it's my honor to present Sheldon Gershon Yakis for the degree Doctor of Music.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Charter of Lebanon Valley College and the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, it is my great pleasure to confer upon Sheldon Gershon Yakis the degree of Doctor of Music with all the rights, honors, and privileges thereunto appertaining, in token of which he receives this diploma and is invested with a hood appropriate to that degree.
I'm Katie Oriel, Associate Professor of Physical Therapy and Chair of the Faculty Steering Committee. The college established the H. Anthony Neidig Award in 1994 for two reasons: to honor a distinguished emeritus professor who served the college for 35 years, and through that time embodied the teaching qualities central to the nature of this community, and to honor a member of the graduating class who represents the qualities that in our statement of purpose, we say we wish to engender in our students. Nominations for the Neidig Award are solicited by the Dean of the Faculty from department chairs who, after consultation with their departmental colleagues, vote to select a recipient. This year's Neidig Award winner is an ACS chemistry major who's graduating with honors with a 3.954 GPA. He has already completed 4 years of undergraduate research, beginning before his freshman year through the High Impact Research First program. He has presented at multiple regional and national research conferences and received a first place award for his research presentation at the 15th Annual Undergraduate Research Symposium in the Chemical and Biological Sciences. This symposium is sponsored by the National Institutes of Health, which attracts more than 200 student submissions. His research and presentations at the National American Chemical Society meetings, regional poster competitions, and the Intercollegiate Student Chemist Convention has led to numerous additional awards, including the Dr. Judith Bond Award, which is awarded to the chemistry major within the boundaries of the Southeastern Pennsylvania section of the American Chemical Society. He has distinguished himself at LVC by selflessly tutoring his fellow students in all levels of the chemistry curriculum, as well as in calculus. For the past 2 years, he has been responsible for running recitation sections for the Organic 1 and 2 chemistry course sequence, which he routinely manages a class of 15 to 25 students in weekly review sessions. And his generosity extends to the local community, where he tutors students in the Anvil-Cleona School District in chemistry, math, and physics. His exhaustive research will soon lead to the co-authoring of a paper with a faculty member to be published in the prestigious international inorganic journal Inorganica Chemica Acta. His chemistry advisor stated that he has produced a level of work that is in the top 1% of the students he has instructed who have gone on to complete PhDs in chemistry or biochemistry, many at Ivy League institutions, and former Nydig Award winners themselves. He has the promise to become a true innovator in the scientific community. His advisor also noted that this young man is that exceptionally talented student that every faculty member dreams of mentoring. He will embody the exceptionalism and promise that this award is meant to honor. Our recipient has been offered full rides at 5 top-tier PhD chemistry programs, including the University of Pennsylvania, the University of North Carolina, and the University of Maryland. Please help me congratulate our 2015 H. Anthony Nydig Award winner, Benjamin Carpenter.
At this point in the program, we ask that the candidates for bachelor degrees please stand. That's you.
You can stay if you want. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the charter of Lebanon Valley College and the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I confer upon you the bachelor's degree. By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Charter of Lebanon Valley College and the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I confer upon you the master's degree, with all the rights, honors, and privileges thereunto appertaining, in the token of which you will receive your diploma. And as a symbol of receiving your degree, I ask you to move your tassels from the right side to the left side.
Please be seated. Will the candidates for doctoral degrees please stand?
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Charter of Lebanon Valley College and the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, I confer upon you the doctoral degree, with all the rights, honors, and privileges thereunto appertaining, in the token of which you will receive your degree. And as a symbol of receiving your degree, I ask you to move your tassels from the right side to the left side. Congratulations, all.
You may now be seated. Now let us proceed with the awarding of degrees. We begin with the officers of the class of 2015 as candidates for bachelor's degrees. President Jill M. Daugherty. Vice President Kylie Lynn Chaklos. Secretary Samuel Calabria. Treasurer Andrew Robert Kittleson. Representative Felicia Danielle Dragon. Representative Stephanie A. Price. Representative Ashley Morgan Smith. Representative Ryan Aaron Salem. Representative Caitlin E. Bradley. And Representative Melanie Reyes Rodriguez. The following candidates are for the Bachelor of Science degree. Bailey A. Benz. Morgan Catherine Heller. Anna Louise Pagos. Jennifer Lee Semensky. Candidates for the Bachelor of Arts degree, Matthew Aldridge. Matthew Christopher Buchevsky. Brittany Elise Baird. Alex Dean Beamsdorfer. Natasha D. Bornhoft. Amanda S. Boyer. Christabel Adeline Braden. Dennis F. Brophy III. Jennifer Michelle Chambers. Matthew J. Suey. Jocelyn Marie Davis. John M. DiCocco. Zay Dong. Michael Robert Daugherty. Ashley Nicole Feld. Jordan T. Ferguson. LaJada Freeland. Brandon A. Gowell. Emily Carolyn George. Lyle Thomas German. Martin Johann Groff. Emily C. Hamm. Tara F. Hart. Waysam Hamdi Hassanin. Kratina Hembrock. Chase Hewitt. Diploma presented by Mr. Russell Hewitt, Public Safety Officer.
Han Mi Huang. Genevieve Hugenbrook. John Matthew Johnston. Caitlin Marie Kane. Adriana Victoria Naur. Zachary Timothy Koss. Anthony Joseph LaFlame. Erica Lynn Laufer. Dina Lincoln. Corey John Lopata. Bradley Daniel McAllister, diploma presented by Mr. Brad McAllister, head men's basketball coach. Zachary T. McCaskill. Carrie Marie McFetters. Nicholas William McMillan. Robin N. Moore. Alyssa Nisley. Kevin O'Connell. Catherine J. O'Hara. Kathleen Elizabeth Payon Mankins. Emily Dawn Peters. Patrick Joseph Reagan. Cody R. Reese. Kimberly E. Rush. Rebecca A. Russo. Christopher Joseph Seos. Emily Faith Schreiber. Caitlin M. Schroding. Nicholas J. Seaton. Amber L. Shea. Nicole E. Shepsky. Jesse Rory Pete Shetram. W. Brian Shoemaker. Kylie L. Simonoff. Cassandra J. Steger. Cammy Lynn Trout. Timothy E. Vandervoort. Lindsay Ann Wayner. Nicole M. Wilhelm. Mary Catherine Anthony Yost. Peter William Icadero. Elizabeth A. Ziner. Candidates for the Bachelor of Music degree, Jesse Christopher Barkey. Nicholas Joseph Cove. John Paul Decker. Jason Edward Dietz. Christopher James Dunlop. Amanda Virginia Fink. Ryan Christopher Gemmel. Nicholas Daniel Harmon. Joshua Eric Hartman. Matthew David Hollenberg. Rachel Suzanne Nettle. Caitlin M. Packard. Janine L. Riley. Cy P. Rossi. Brianna Elizabeth Steinitz. Logan Elizabeth Thompson. Daniel J. Weinel. Samuel Yoder.
Candidates for the Bachelor of Science degree, Kevin J. Agnew. Ines Ottensteiner. Kristen Lynn Alt. Wendy Melinda Autenreath, her diploma presented by Dr. Kristen Angsted, trustee. Kenneth Jeffrey Ayer. John Isaac Baer. Megan Elizabeth Barun. Derek Jeffrey Baum. Stephanie L. Behrens. Zachary Joel Biedler. Joseph Theodore Bieland. Mitchell Stephen Bell. Nathan J. Bell. Joseph Andrew Bennett. Jonathan R. Bensing. Luke Borden Bergeson. Jordan Jonathan Balicki. Joshua Allen Bishop. Sarah M. Black. Cody A. Blankenhorn. Marjorie Jane Blum. Zachary Boisfert. Elliot A. Bonds. Jessica Rachel Boyd. Rachel Suzanne Boyle. Haley Lorray Brightbill. Pamela Marie Brogan. Kayla Jo Berger. Laura Calderon. Eric Michael Campbell. Stefan Caporaletti. Amelia L. Capuano. Colin M. Catherman. Caitlin Rose Chamberlain. Cole Dio Chamberlain. Stephen Isaac Christ. Kayla Leslie Confer. Kelsey Stephen Kraus. Katie Elizabeth Dasher. Maggie Michelle Davis. Tyler James Dean. Elizabeth A. DeCembrino. Go right. Connor Reardon DiStefano. Samantha C. Devine. Jeffrey Paul Dickens. Brittany Patricia Deerwechter. Casey Ruth Dietrich. Kevin Donahue. Allison Marie Dooley. Christina Marie Duran. Amanda Douglas. Amy Margaret Dundorf. Jennifer Marie Durofchuk. Nicholas C. Durofchuk. Dominic James Duvernois. Matthew Ryan Easter. Brian Eck. Rachel Marie Eiler. Cassandra Lynn Falk. Sabrina Louise Fellenbaum. Samantha Jane Fellenbaum. Jane Ann Eileen Furrer. Sarah Marie Forey. Jonathan Fogelman. Brett Michael Frazier. Corinne Jolene Frederick. Melanie Lynn Frederick. Kyle Wesley Frank. Adam Taylor Fuhrer. Kim Dahay Gailey. Ashley Marie Galgan. Janesh P. Gandhi. Mark Allen Garraway. William J. Gartrell. Stephanie Francis George. Taylor Gerchok. Samantha Mary Ginder. Andrew Lewis Geltz. Stephen Daniel Goodman. Trinda Marie Goodman. Lauren Marie Grauer. Corinne Lee Grouser. Christian Abraham Grove, diploma presented by Dr. Robert Klein, former athletic team physician. Amanda Catherine Greigel. Amanda Nicole Harding. Sarah Jane Harleman. Michael Harnish. Caitlin M. Helwig. Caitlin Jean Hensler. Amber Lynn Hetler. Casey Helen Hurst. Kendra Catherine Hoack. Benjamin Scott Horner. Robin Lynn Holman. Natalie Margaret Horrocks.
Cheyenne Hostetter. Madeline Bowles Humphrey. Jan Aiko Ikeda. Kelsey Marie Jackson. Jillian Rochelle Jacobs. Emily Beth Johansson. Daniel W. Johnson III. Patrick Dimitri Jones. Rachel Elizabeth Jones. Dylan S. Kapp. Jacob Kasprensky. Elisa L. Keek. Brandon L. Keller. Rachel Jo Kelly. Andrea Jordan Kelso. Eric Thomas Kennedy. Isaac Kim. Jennifer M. Kint. Kathleen Elizabeth King. Alexander Robert Kishbaugh. Yeah. Stephanie Ann Kleinfelter. Nathan John Kleinschuster. Edna Jane Klein. Kayla Mary Klump. Zachary Andrew Necht. Amanda M. Knitter. Kristen Nicole Cornsey. Nicole L. Crackham. Hillary Ann Krajewski. Bradley Alexander Krasanitz. Misha Kishan Lala. Alyssa Lancaster. Heather Lynn LaSalle. Tyler Daryl Lauderman. Cassandra Marie Lehman. Mary Catherine Lemons. William Edward Lewis. Travis J. Light. Robin M. Lily Foreman. Brody J. Lipset. Andrea Lynn Lasowski. Andrew James Livingston. Cody Joseph Lloyd. Shen Liu. Matthew David Lebowski. Caitlin Elizabeth Luckenbaugh. Hai V. Liu. Tyler M. McCauley. Suzette Jane Madinette. Caitlin N. Madara. Carrie A. Mahul. Stephanie Ann Mirano. Alyssa Michelle Marino. Trent Michael Mars. Joshua Martin. Bethany Lee Mary. Anise B. Maurer. Lauren Ashley McCullen. Connor Patrick McDonald. Travis Leonard McFetters. Devin N. McCain, diploma presented by Dr. Luis Laguna, Professor of Psychology. Kayla J. McCain, Diploma also presented by Dr. Luis Laguna. Matthew Joseph McMonagall. John Michael Meck. Craig Ryan Miller. Seth Michael Miller. Tyson Allen Miller. Laura Misevich. Brittany Catherine Morse. Michael Mullen. Alyssa Murphy. Brian Patrick Murphy. Michelle Francis Murray. Casey J. Musselman. Matthew Myers. Rebecca Elizabeth Myers. Chelsea Renee Newell. Laura Ann Noble. Adam G. Obaya. Lauren Colleen O'Boyle. Jessica S. Oliveri. Nicholas John Pantalone, degree awarded in memoriam. His diploma is received by his sister, Rachel Hoover. Nicholas Robert Pappas. Zachary Enrique Pardo. Chelsea Pastel. Jacqueline Claire Payton. Clarissa Marie Perez. Sarah E. Paczynski. Brandon Michael Pop. Michael Pugh Jr. Adam Brian Rabenold. Lauren Michaela Rohde. Jonathan M. Riley Jr. Emily Robinault. Alicia Rose Roberto.
Kaylin Ray Ryan. Christy Sabors. Melissa E. Shelzo. Caitlin Diane Schleline. Caitlin A. Shoemaker. Taylor Eileen Sieber. Caitlin Noel Sensenig. Jordan Taylor Shankroff. Tyler Troy Shawl. Zachary Thomas Shepherd. Carolyn Marie Shervin. Jordan Nicole Shields. Samantha Ann Shimp. Carly Francis Schrader. Brittany Marie Shu. Alyssa N. Schultz. Megan Y. Sittler. Heather Ann Smith. Michael Benjamin Smith. Paige Lauren Smith. Mariah Lynn Smolka. Adam Paul Soltis. Douglas J. Stansley. Crystal Steenwick. Joshua Scott Stamen. Laura N. Steo. Dana Nicole Stockdale. Andrew Stoltfus. Lucas Andrew Stelfer. Tori Elizabeth Stramera. Amanda Jordan Stroll. Tori Lynn Summy. Mara E. Sunderland. Joseph Ryan Swartz. Daryl Sean Sweeper Jr. Mark Swokel. Candace Lee Tanner. Kimberly Tevis. Kevin Daniel Tilly. Gina Ann Toomey. Alexander Lewis Toppin. Jacob Joseph Topping. Travis Allen Trutt. Katie B. Ulrich. Caitlin Elizabeth Umberger. Jenny Marie Upton. Aaron Lynn Van Buskirk. Patrick Varis. Nicole A. Vasulio. Arielis Marie Vasquez. Andrew Michael Walker. Taylor Walls. Samantha Elise Walter. Richard Lee Weber III. Christopher Michael Weidensall. Jacob Samuel Morris Weitzman. Jevin Josiah Michael Weixler. Ryan Joseph West. Emily Lynn White. Brooks Wesley Whiting. Zachary T. Wehrman. Daniel Wesley Wiley Jr. Clayton Elwood Williard. Jordan Lee Wilson. Sari S. Winston. Rebecca Ruth Wise. Sarah E. Whitmer. Kristen Marie Whitmire. Andrew D. Woolley. Caitlin Erin Ray. Rachel Elizabeth Yater. Laura E. Young. Jessica Lynn Zaleski. Candidates for the Bachelor of Science in Chemistry, Benjamin Allen Carpenter. Timothy Gary Carroll. Stephen Dunmoyer. Caitlin M. McCardle. Candidate for the Bachelor of Science in Medical Technology, Kayla Lynn Sigley. Candidates for the Master of Business Administration, Adita Bahatia. Sarah Elizabeth Bryan. Benjamin Michael Delp. Melissa Ann Dorsey. John Mowery Fry. David Adam Hoffman. Brian Robert Lauthert. Megan Lee McDonald. Diane Dugard McIntyre. Trung Van Nguyen. George C. Pediakyle. Gerard Peralta Saplala. Michael J. Siss. Joy D. Springer. Nathaniel S. Strike. Taylor Emerson Walden. Joseph James Wysock III.
Candidates for the Master of Music Education degree, Brian Neil Barch. Edward J. Krenicki. Andrew T. Spots. Candidates for the Doctor of Physical Therapy degree. Dr. Victoria Ann Broderick. Dr. Megan Elizabeth Clark. Dr. Alicia Lynn Farrell. Dr. Amanda Nicole Hanna. Dr. Emily Margaret Harvey. Dr. Kelsey Nicole Hepner. Dr. Leanne Nicole Hyatt. Dr. Katarina Krista Karnas. Dr. Devin Whitney Keim. Dr. Sarah Elizabeth Lloyd. Dr. Derek C. Lonenecker. Dr. Eric M. Martin. Dr. Aaron Caitlin McCarthy. Dr. Kelsey Ray Miller. Dr. Morgan Lindley Miller. Dr. Sarah Nicole Munoz. Dr. Lindsay Teresa Nice. Dr. Michelle L. Nolt. Dr. Lauren Nicole Pyle. Dr. Brianna Michael Roman. Dr. Gia Russell. Dr. Shanna Elizabeth Spores. Dr. Nicholas Joseph Schultz. Dr. Stephanie Lynn Sokola. Dr. Natalie Joe Snyder. Dr. Olivia Julia Snyder. Dr. Samantha N. Stewart. Dr. Jennifer Nicole Strack. Dr. Matthew Paul Turner. Dr. Rachel Lee Turner. Dr. Kelsey Janelle Wallen. And Dr. Kristen Marie Wan. President Thane, it is my pleasure to present the Lebanon Valley College class of 2015. I would now like to invite Jill Daugherty, 2015 class president, to the podium. Jill?
Greetings, faculty, trustees, administrators, family, friends, and perhaps most importantly, classmates. I'm Jill Daugherty, and I'm the 2015 class president. And before I start my speech, I want to give a shout out to the softball team and girls lacrosse team. Go Valley! Has it ever occurred to you that graduation day is a bit like looking through a scrapbook? It's full of pictures jumbled together, which help to make up our lives. There are the images of our growing years with family and friends. There are pictures of our activities, sports, clubs, music groups, and many more of many of our successes and maybe even a few of our setbacks. And now, finally, we add a new page, the wonderful excitement of today, our graduation day. Somewhere between 4 and however many years it took, we're leaving here, leaving behind the place we've called home, a place where we came in unsure of the friends we would make, unaware of the amazing experiences ahead, and unexpecting of how many people would touch our lives. We leave it all behind and call it unforgettable. I stand before you today, proud to be a Dutchman and forever inspired by our Lebanon Valley College community, home of multiple MAC champions, distinguished academic programs, nationally recognized community service efforts, and now 414 more accomplished graduates. To everyone who touched our lives, we say thank you. To the parents who stood by us no matter what, to professors who tried to instill in us a passion for learning and drive to become better every single day. To administrators who wanted to make our college experiences as amazing as possible. To advisors who help us decide what path to take. To friends who were there for Chicken Tender Thursdays, random rate night Walmart trips, bus rides, study sessions, and everything in between. And to all those others we depend on here at Lebanon Valley College to make it an unforgettable experience, we thank you. To the class of 2015, congratulations. I look forward to the accomplishments you are about to achieve and wish you the greatest luck as we leave our home. Go Valley!
Before we all rise and sing the alma mater, I'd like to thank the student musicians under the direction of Professor Chris Hefner, and for all those people who made this beautiful occasion so special, Vicki Trosel and all of the facilities staff, thank you so much for all of your good work. And now please rise and join me in the singing of the alma mater and remain standing for the benediction. The words of the alma mater are on the last page of your program.
To thee, dear alma mater, this ringing song we raise, a song that's fraught with gladness, a song that's filled with praise. We cannot help but love thee. Our hearts are full and free. Full well we know the debt we owe to
immediately following the benediction and during the recessional, please remain in your seats. The president, trustees, and faculty will form an honor line through which our new graduates will march. The graduates will then be led into the Arnold Arena, where you are welcome to meet them after the recessional has ended. Please feel free to use both exits to meet your graduates there. Class of 2015, you have graduated. Congratulations. And now receive this benediction. By God's grace, may the gifts and talents He has bestowed on each of you give you the courage and wisdom to become the best version of yourselves and to serve those in need in the communities in which you will live. Do justice, love mercy, walk humbly with your God, and may God sustain you and your families through all that today and tomorrow will bring. Alleluia, amen.
Thank you. What's that?
John, come kiss me.
We don't have that part. I'll take your music. Thank you guys very much.
I said you didn't cry.